The Spanish Grand Prix has been a permanent fixture on the Formula One calendar for over 30 years now, and for good reason. Do you remember Michael Schumacher's absolute dominance here in that rain-soaked Grand Prix in 1996? That day he took his first ever victory for Ferrari, and we've had many more iconic moments since. It's 730 metres from pole position down to a slippery turn one here, the first of 16 corners around this 2.89 mile racetrack. The long, wide turn three and the uphill right-hander of turn nine can both be taken full throttle in the right conditions, but I doubt very much we'll be seeing any of that today. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of turn one. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are three main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Lee lines up on pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Verstappen, Charles Leclerc, and Vettel, Albon, Ricciardo, Perez, and Lance Stroll, Sainz, Norris, Pierre Gasly, and Ocon, Grosjean, Magnussen, Kimi Raikkonen, and Daniil Kvyat, Giovinazzi, Russell, Schumacher, and Nicholas Latifi. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish.
Okay, our system checks are good.
We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. That's a strong start. Well done. Thank you. was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. We're monitoring somewhere on the ICE. Be aware that we will start to see a loss of power. Engine is showing small signs of wear. Power output will be down. Definitely think we need to stay on this tire a bit. We're leading our teammate by 30.3 seconds. Heavy rain will be staying with us for a while now, at least a 20-minute window of heavy rain. Flag. is dropping back. We're seeing a gap form. The circuit's definitely looking better than it was a few minutes ago. If we could just move a bit more of that standing water, we might be able to get onto the intermediates. to teammate behind is 57.2 seconds. Catching you at a rate of about 2 seconds a lap. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Heavy rain will be staying with us for a while now, at least a 20-minute window of heavy rain. Tyre condition is still looking good. A new fastest lap of the race. There's three laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Okay, you're creating some breathing space between you and the car behind by a few seconds per lap. That's number six. Congratulations on a well-deserved winning streak.
They've done it then. A spectacular victory here in Spain and a massive confidence boost going into the next race. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
Well, keeping their tyre temperatures up in the tricky wet conditions was really important. There's not much grip out there at the best of times, and it's 10 times worse if you're out there on cold tyres. So the way they kept the rubber in its proper operating window was a huge advantage today.
The faces on our top three look so incredibly happy as they make their way up to the podium. A much-deserved victory and a brilliant performance from them all. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Lee increases their championship lead. Some amazing talents out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Well, for me, it's got to be Lewis Hamilton. The multiple world champion may be the boring choice at this point, but you can't argue that he's a driver deserving of his reputation.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from Red Bull this time out, and they improve their position in the championship. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to join us again as we continue to bring you the latest excitement in Formula One.